recently built and never actually lived in, an MSF team took over this house in the middle of June and turned it into a hospital.
We managed to turn this house into a hospital with about 15 hospital beds, an intensive care unit with 3 or 4 beds, a recovery room, an operating theatre, a small lab and a sterilisation unit.
Most of the patients are men with conflict-related injuries caused by tank shelling and bombing. This patient, who is 17, was shot in the back 18 days ago. After being operated on somewhere, imprisoned and then released, he managed to get to the MSF hospital. The seriousness of his abdominal injuries meant that he absolutely had to have more surgery.
It's possible that he may require an additional operation if he continues to put out a lot from the fistula, it doesn't close, and he develops any complications. So he has a difficult road ahead.
Some 20% of the wounded are children and young people under the age of 20. Between 5% and 10% are women. Along with emergency cases, MSF also treats patients whose conditions have stabilized.
We also get patients who arrive in a stable condition but with complications. For example, we see patients with infections related to the poor conditions during previous treatment in clandestine structures, structures set up by doctors from the opposition.
The fighting, the difficulties with obtaining supplies, and the lack of ambulances are all challenges that need to be overcome. But the hospital is definitely functional, and the team has already performed 224 operations.